With extreme cases of hoarding affecting one in every 50 of us, specialist cleaners can often be called in to help those in crisis.
Right, let's roll.
Cue sisters Yvonne and Angela, who have over 40 years of cleaning experience between them.
And you're still making me go out and hoover like a raving lunatic. Could you imagine doing anything else?
Yes, lying on a beach.
There's never a morning when I really don't want to go to work. It's always interesting, there's always something different. You never know what you're going to find.
Today, they're heading to Southend to meet a 70-year-old whose house...
Can we get to the door without
breaking our necks?
..is at bursting point.
Oh, hi, you sweetheart.
Hi.
I'm Yvonne.
Hi,
I'm
nice
Angela.
To meet you.
Nice
Hello.
To meet you, darling.
Right
then, are you going to show us what we've got to do?
No.
Come on, it can't be that bad.
Let's have a look.
Pam has lived in this one-bed flat, stacked from floor to ceiling with books, boxes and bric-a-brac, for the last 30 years.
The hole is the clearest.
This is the clearest?
Yeah, this is the clearest. I'll breathe in and hope for the best, and I'll...
Right, breathe in then.
Right.
I've never had to shimmy into a property before.
How come in, Pam?
Homeless.
How do you live in here? How?
Well...
How long have you lived here, Pam?
30 years.
30?
30 years.
Yep.
So is this 30 years worth of...
build-up?
Yep.
Along with her trusty disabled dog, Crystal, Pam is often found browsing the local second-hand shops for trinkets and knick-knacks.
If I get depressed, I go to comfort buying. But then I'll give it to people. Sometimes I buy it, it's a bargain, and I'll give it away to someone, because I like to make people happy.
I see you've got a Steptoe and Son video. That's quite fitting for you, Pam, isn't
yeah.
it? Yes.
I find it quite hard to get rid of things. Because when you're growing up with nothing, you hang on to it, you look after it.
But 30 years of not throwing anything out means Pam's kitchen is packed to the rafters.
Oh, my God, you actually even store things in your microwave. I've never known anyone use a microwave for storage before.
Well,
that's a new one.
It keeps it cool, doesn't it?
And she's not seen her own bath in decades.
There's actually a bath under all of this.
I'd like to see it.
Nice to see it.
Yeah.
I'd like to see it, because I actually don't believe you. There's a bath under there.
Where do you sleep?
Down the garden, somewhere else, or shed.
What?
The shed?
Yeah.
Forced out of the house by her hoarding habit, Pam's been sleeping in her tiny garden shed for the last 6 years.
Is it?
And she's even beginning to run out of room here.
Are you out here in the winter?
Yeah. I'm a winter person. I've got Nordic blood in my veins. I know I can't sort of stay like this, but... because I'm getting old, don't I?
I know.
Yeah. Listen, we can make this better, Pam. We can make this better for you, give you a better life.
Yep.
Our aim is to get that amazing, funny, quirky lady out of that shed.
Sleeping
into
in the
her home.
The first job is to see what's behind a locked door Pam lost the keys to 3 years ago.
Oh my God. It's all empty boxes. Once we get them out, we're through.
Pam,
we've got an empty
space.
Cupboard.
We've got an empty cupboard. We've got space.
Oh, this is exciting.
With two new rooms to use for storage, the girls set about clearing Pam's colossal hoard.
Planning here now is we've created a massive space, so we're hoping to bring everything from the dining room and the kitchen into here and keep everything.
All of Pam's possessions can be stored in the spare rooms, reclaiming some much-needed living space.
Oh, my God.
What?
Yvonne! That one's had its head squashed.
That one's still got a bit of fur on.
They've been there a long time. Look, we can move. When we started, you couldn't even crawl through here, could you?
All of Pam's possessions can be stored in the spare rooms, reclaiming some much-needed living space.
We are getting much closer to our goal. Pam's bed inside. We've just got to find the space to put it now.
Hey, it's up on my head.
Believe it or not,
There's a bath under here. It was up to here not long ago. But now we're going to empty it and we're going to clean it.
With hoarding affecting up to 5% of the population, it's a condition that can affect anyone.
What's quite shocking, and most people don't understand about hoarding, is that it's police, it's doctors, it's dentists, it's shopkeepers, it's everyone.
I get excited about everything that I find in these properties, to be honest, because I'm like a mini hoarder myself.
Nearly all hoarders know exactly what they've got.
Yeah.
How they know what they've got,
I don't know.
Do not know, because there is that much stuff in their houses, but they know. If you've thrown something, they'll know.
4 days ago, Pam's home was filled to the rafters with 3 decades' worth of junk. And it was so bad that she'd been forced to sleep in her shed for the last 6 years. But 20 storage boxes, over 100 black bin bags, and 2 mummified mice later.
Hello, lovely lady.
Hello.
Welcome to your new home.
Oh, look at this. Yeah, I can dance on a spout, but you can dance even more in here, can't
you? Can
you?
You can walk in. You can walk in. You can stand
straight. Yeah, we can
stand straight.
Before, Pam's dining room was full to the brim and uninhabitable. But now it's clean and spacious, with room enough for a bed.
I can't believe it. I haven't seen the windows for a couple of years. Normally you can't stop me talking, but I'm speechless. I can't believe it. I am so happy. Thank you.
Despite being called a bathroom, Pam hadn't seen her bath in over 2 decades.
Oh, wow.
Let alone been able to use it. And now...
When was the last time you did that?
Years and years ago.
Bye, Pam.
Bye.
We've met so many hoarders. My God, this was a tough one.
Yeah, she's one of the most extreme, isn't she?
Thank you very much.
Okay. Bye, sweetheart. Bye. You take care, my darling.
Bye.
Bye.
Is laughing the old dog yet? Are you happy there? Nice, isn't it, eh? Got a new lease of life. I had given up. Thank you.